Hello, I'm Georgie from Jamie's Food Team, and I'm going to show you a great way to prepare partridge. To start, we're going to flavour our partridge with just a little bit of salt and pepper, quite simple. We're going to drizzle them and massage in the seasoning. We've got a great flavour, so we don't need to do too much. So just give them a little rub, massage in those flavours. And then we're just going to stuff them with some herbs. We've got some thyme and rosemary. I'm just going to snip my rosemary in half. It's really big and woody. Just poke them in. Don't worry if they stick out a little bit. You don't have to be too perfect. Just, you want to flavour from the inside. So as they're roasting, all those gorgeous oils go into the partridge itself. Trim off any little woody bits at the end. And now I've got some pancetta. You can use smoked streaky bacon if you like. Whichever's easiest to get hold of, or whatever you've got at home is fine. And we're just going to tie this onto the partridge itself, just to secure it on. Partridge are so small, you don't really need to truss them like you would do a chicken or a bigger bird, because they're only tiny, so the wings and the thighs aren't going to really poke out like they would do of a chicken. So all we need to do is drape over our pancetta or bacon and then just secure them on. Don't worry too much about being perfect, because it'll all crinkle and shrivel up in the oven. And then we're going to just tie it on with a piece of string to secure it in place. Super crispy in the oven and impart lovely flavour onto the top of the partridge, and keep it a bit moist at the same time. The fat will baste it almost. And don't go crazy on the salt when you're seasoning them, because obviously bacon's quite salty. As you can see, I'm not being too perfect with my draping. I'm not worrying too much about lining them out perfectly, because as the bacon, pancetta, whatever you're using cooks, it's going to crinkle up and shrivel up all around the partridge, just like that. I'm just going to wash my hands. All you need to do is get some string. It's really simple. You want to make sure the string is long enough to go around the partridge all the way, and a little bit extra for a knot. Cut your string, put it underneath, and just tie it like that. Doing it that way, you're just securing on the bacon. And give it a little pull. You want it quite tight, taut, not too much. You can tie a little bow if you like, knot, whatever's easiest. And do the same for the others. Put the partridge on top. Just tie it around like that. As you see, there's a natural groove there anyway. And the string will just sit in nicely. And again, you can tie it in a knot, that's fine. You don't have to do it in a bow. It just looks quite sweet. Just like that. And again, just trim off the excess string. And that's just going to keep the pancetta in place. And there you go. Then all you want to do is transfer your little birds into a snug-fitting roasting tray or baking dish. Put them in. You could even put a little drizzle, final drizzle of olive oil, just to, that will just make the pancetta go really lovely and crispy. And all you need to do now is preheat your oven to about 200 degrees and roast the little partridges for about 30 minutes until they're golden and crispy, and they'll be absolutely delicious. And there you have it, a great way to prepare partridge.